Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Spice Squadron podcast, episode 34.
Welcome.
Aloha. This is a very special episode that we're going to be having today, one that I've been hankering for, been pitching every single week. Reese is like, no, I don't want to do it.
I definitely
finally wore him down. He's finally going to appreciate the art of Star Wars Unlimited.
Okay, I was going to say, I was going to interject, making me look bad. I was going to interject and say, and this is an episode you can probably expect from every set.
Absolutely. And to be very clear, we both really wanted to do this episode. We really wanted to showcase the art that we love from
this. We, since day one, have definitely been on the camp of anytime anyone's like, I hate this artwork, we're both like, why? We really like all the artwork. Even the goofy Han leader and goofy Chewie leader.
Has special places in our hearts.
Exactly. I know they're goofy, but like at least Han and Chewie are goofy.
You are going to be seeing us with our phones out. Yes. That's because we do want to make sure we're saying A, names as correctly as we can, and B, making sure we get all the right artworks for the right people. We don't want to be saying the wrong thing by accident.
I know what all the art looks like, but I just still need a list to double check who did the artworks together. So essentially, kind of a bit of structure for this video. We're probably going to do a brief chat about the art stream FFG just did. Just, there wasn't a lot of information about the new set in there. A lot of artwork, a lot of really fun stuff. Mm. I was actually a really informative stream. I quite enjoyed hearing back.
Yeah, I really like this piece of art.
I don't know which one it is, but there was a lot shown off. It's probably going to be Aphra. this guy over here listening to the audiobooks.
They're good?
They are good. And then we'll break down one by one some of our favorite card artworks from set one, talk about the artists, what we like about the artwork specifically in particulars. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to be discussing a few of the cards that they did. And at the end of the video, we're going to cover off some of the artwork we've seen for set two, and maybe do a bit of theory crafting. That kind of stuff's just off the cusp for us. We're going to talk about
what we like.
See how
much time we have when we get there.
Yeah. I know this isn't probably what you're usually looking forward to about the game and stuff, but at the end of the day, we really want to make this video, and we think a lot of you guys will enjoy it as well. So let's dive into the wonderful artwork of Swoop.
But before we begin, if you want to, please chuck your favorite artwork from the set down in the comments.
Yeah,
let
sure.
us know which what your favorite artwork of the set is.
Honestly, we love a lot of it, and I think it's really important for you guys to let us know as well. It's just cool stuff. I really like discussing the artwork with people. Look, we answer pretty much every comment we get. So the more comments we get, the better. We love talking to you guys. So please let us know down below. But the artwork stream was really good. So it was Xander, Tyler, I can't remember his name, and he is the lead art director, and now I look like a fake fan.
His name is up here.
And they discussed the processing for artworks, how they go about talking with the artists, commissioning portfolios, deadlines, how they go about the changing processes. Tyler talked for a while about writing the prompt, and how that gets passed along to the artist and what changes need to be made. And it's a really interesting process. The stream is one of their shorter ones, but I still think it's worth the watch. It's really enjoyable, let alone for the set two artwork, but just being able to hear the process they go through.
It's really interesting. And at the end of the day, like, a lot of the artwork they showed is so nice. And we'll get to that a little bit later, but man, it's crazy how much consistently great artwork that this game is pumping out. And I know there were, like, at the beginning of people being like, well, they should just use stills from the movies, but I think this is just such a better direction to take this from.
That's really boring, I won't lie. It's really boring, and they actually address that in the thing. They say it's really jarring because you don't want to have a Han Solo card in your hand where he's, you know, it's Harrison Ford back in the 70s, and then right next to it, and then right next to it, it's animated Captain Rex from 2008. Or you're building a Clone Wars deck, and it will, like, animation has come a long way since it originally started. So if you built a Clone Wars era deck from the animated TV show, half your deck is going to look completely different for when the animation style's updated and changed. Like, even the ones where, like, it got later on, and then it took a break, and in season 6, when the final season, the animation style had a huge bump.
Yeah. And so, at the end of the day, so they're like finding a way to consistently have a style. And I know there's lots of different artists working and they do have different styles, and there's ones we prefer and ones we prefer a little bit less. But at the end of the day, it makes a really interesting thing. And we get these artworks like the ones that we're going to be talking about that just wow us.
Yeah.
And even if cards aren't great, they can be commons.
True.
But the artwork is just something that you're just like, damn, this is interesting. There's stuff going on. It's always dynamic. Yeah. And it's just really cool.
Most of the time as well, you'll find that 99% of players care more about the mechanics of the cards than they do characters and stuff like that. But then there are a lot of players like myself who will run a card in their deck because they just like the art. Like, people will be like, but you could just run this guy instead. And I'm like, yes, but he's not a little guy. And I want to run a little guy like Salacious B. Crumb. Or other cards, for instance. And Tyler also said that. He was like, I've seen people run decks and build decks purely because they're like, ooh, love this artwork.
Mm, absolutely.
But I think that overall, Swoo's actually done a really good job just like nailing down good looking cards and getting, and especially with set two, we've seen like a really more uniform in terms of style of the cards so far. Like you can still tell artists are distinct and everything, but set one were definitely had some variations in style, which I liked quite a lot. But set two definitely feels more tied together. And I think that's really good. I think either way, there's gorgeous artwork and I think we should take it away. So, yep. Do you want to go first or should I go first?
You go first, my dude.
I am a man of great bias. And, oh yes, before we start this, art is subjective. You may not like it. We like it. At the end of the day, yeah, who cares? And if you don't like artwork we've picked and you want to tell us what your favorite is, once again, leave it down below. We'll gladly have a discussion with you. But I am a man of great bias, and thus my favorite card artwork, one of them at least, has to be Kanan. Jarrus, Jedi Revealed by Sandra Schlewinski.
Yep. Schlewinski. Sure, seen this one coming.
Definitely going to butcher some of these names. I'm so sorry to the artist, but Sandra Schlewinski, her name will be up here.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I love this artwork. I think that this really captures my favorite scene of all of Star Wars. Mm-hmm. Obviously, we've talked about it before. I don't need to go into depth, but Kanan lighting up his lightsaber for the first time and Callus telling all of the stormtroopers to fire upon the Jedi is one of my favorite scenes. It is my favorite scene in all of Star Wars. And I think they capture this incredibly well. This is the moment after when the stormtroopers started firing on him. I love this card because this card, the framing in this card is action. The background of it is an orange blur showing that it's all the focus is on Kanan, who is, his colors are in very stark contrast to the orange. And it shows a lot of action. You can see the blaster bolt ricocheting off his lightsaber. He's in a combat pose. I think they really captured the essence of the character as well. He looks like it sounds silly, but I look at this and I know it's Kanan. And I know exactly what scene it is without needing the title of the card. If they just showed us this artwork as they would have in the general reveals, like they've been doing so, I would have known exactly who this was and exactly what point in time this was without even know. I probably could have guessed the name of the card if you showed me the artwork based on that. And I think that is an incredibly good testament to the artist. I adore this work. Mm. And I have this in hyperspace and I have this in hyperspace foil. It is gorgeous.
He's very, very pretty.
And of course I'm biased. It's my favorite character. Sue me, but I think that it's extra special when, yes, my favorite character was always going to be in it.
Mm.
It's extra special when the artwork of your favorite character is done justice, and that's exactly how I feel with this card. I love it. Sandra has also done other artworks, including Spectre Mum. Hera, the Hera card leader.
Hera leader.
The Leia leader as well. Mm. She did both of the green hero leaders in the set, which I think is, once again, a testament to these characters look accurate to who they are.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think they are awesome. I love both of them having the contrast of Hera's in the pilot seat and Leia's giving orders on Echo Base, on Hoth. And then finally, a banger that I think when we came out, but before all of the art was revealed, when this artwork came out, we both stated that this was some of the most beautiful artwork. And at that point in time, I believe it was your favorite piece of artworks, Aggression. Because that card looks awesome.
That
Kylo
is a very,
Ren looks
very pretty card.
So
that card
cool.
in the hyperspace foil looks just as good as I hoped it would.
It looks incredible. I really like the utilization of background Sandra does, where minimalistic colored backgrounds that are blurred or have action lines on them to indicate a swing or to indicate action going on without having to clutter up the image.
Absolutely.
I think it's incredible use of it. So I absolutely love this, but I can't talk about Kanan all day, even though I wish I could. What's one of your favorite cards? Riddle me.
One I'm going to start with. I'm going to start with a card that I put in every single yellow deck to the detriment of the deck sometimes. But I love this artwork so much, and I love the ability so much. So I think it's one of my favorite cards to just throw in yellow decks, and that is Snapshot Reflexes. I think this card is really, really cool, and you'll find a lot of my favorite artworks in the set are the more stylized artworks. It's kind of what I gravitate towards. And this shows it off perfectly. This kind of stylized, like the Dark Mandalorian on that bright yellow background, while it's not, like, and the smoke as well.
The dust being kicked up, the poncho flying back.
It's one of the things I was saying before, right? They're so dynamic, and they're so that's so refreshing in a card game to have these dynamic poses. And I think this pulls it off really, really well in a way that, like, perfectly contrasts him to the background and perfectly and it's one of those cards, and I do really appreciate this when a card just screams I'm a yellow card.
Yeah, when they have nice color matching the color. Remember when we saw the artwork for Cunning and we both were like that's
Cunning,
and then Aggression as well. Both cards done by, like, once again, Thomas Sandra. But again, cards like this, I think cards like Bodhi Rook as well are very yellow. So I know we're not going to talk. We're going to talk about it a little bit later. I'm very excited to go into depth about this artwork, but the Lando Calrissian card artwork of Donald Glover, Childish Gambino. For me, it's a yellow leader, and if you look at the artwork, yellow background, yellow, same as that artwork.
Yeah.
One thing I want to say about this before you get back to it is, I love Snapshot Reflex's artwork because I think that it does something very important to the Mandalorian series, and I think that this artwork captures the genre really well. This artwork screams spaghetti western, a fistful of credits to me, and that's exactly what the genre of the Mandalorian
absolutely
is.
And it's one of those, like, it's one of the cards that captures the feel of the show that it's in,
and that's so important.
And it's so absolutely, and I think that's going to be something really interesting to see as we go forward, how well these cards capture not only in ability and in, like, they've been done a really good job at the moment of matching ability to kind of thematics, but the art of, like, what is a little bit more fun and free, whereas one what is more kind of like, and this is just straight out of a western. This is him drawing it up.
He's walking forward in the town, the wind is blowing.
Yeah, absolutely. It's, you can feel this scene.
Yeah, I can hear the music, the
absolutely,
like, every time I look at this card. And interestingly enough, I think this card matches up really well with the Mandalorian leader artwork, because it kind of looks like Snapshot Reflex's art, but we're looking at the POV facing towards the Mandalorian, which I think is really cool. But I think it's incredible when an artist can match tone and genre into artwork.
Absolutely. This artist is Amelie Hutt, and she's done a bunch of other artwork for SWU as well.
Some really good ones.
Some really, really good ones. I'll just throw off a couple here to talk about. She did both the Iden and the Jin leaders. Both
gorgeous
of which,
leaders.
Fantastic leaders.
Yeah, awesome leaders.
I really like Iden's background. I think the like that kind of blurred, like, it's one of those things where it's like, if you looked at it by itself, it's not much, but it allows the focus to be drawn so well to Iden in that art, that it really complements it really well. And I think that was a really good job
in
that leader.
Also, one thing I really like about the Iden leader is it captures Iden's cool demeanor in battle. The rest of the background is going crazy and nuts, but she is calm, collected, she's clear. I like Jin's art a lot because, again, You can tell it's a yellow leader. I like her dynamic pose as she's darting. So
one of the other ones that I really want to talk about is it binds all things.
Ugh.
Like, talk about a card that shows its color. Like, this is blue? Another huge one. And it's one of those scenes that you can almost feel as well. It feels cold and it feels desperate in a way. And like, that the scene portrayed. I'll talk about it quickly. We haven't picked any showcases as our like main cards for this because it feels one of us has picked a showcase, but to me, I was like, I want to showcase more of the showcases are designed to be the best art. And, like, I understand that.
My last card is a showcase.
You could pick five showcases as your five favorite cards easily.
Of course,
but I will say
could.
That this. Only is actually one of my favorite showcases of the set, and that is the Boba Fett showcase.
I think that's like everyone's favorite showcase. It's, judging by its $900 price tag,
that is,
definitely AUD. It's definitely.
We have to keep making that.
There is a lot I could say about the Boba Fett showcase, and I don't need to. Look at it. There you go.
It is so perfectly Boba Fett.
It's actually perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah. It captures like the really gritty, rough nature. I like how his armor's damaged, but I don't want to talk too much about Boba Fett because everyone talks about
Boba Fett. Let's move on to the second one.
Your boy loves his troopers.
He does. Loves his troopers.
And recently, one thing I've started doing is I'm painting Legion. And one of the things that heavily influenced me and my Star Wars Legion army is actually the artwork from Star Wars Unlimited. I'm playing Empire, and I picked Death Troopers and Shore Troopers with Director Krennic because I love how they look. And when I was painting the miniatures, I used the card arts as references.
Yeah.
Death Trooper by, I do not know how to pronounce this well, I will butcher this one, by Boya Pindado. They captured what I like to think a Death Trooper just going into battle perfectly. The Death Trooper's on the rock of like on the shore, set moving up. They've got such a commanding presence because that's them compared to other troopers. They escort and they lead their special forces. He's got like his one hand as a curled in fist, like the brave, like it looks like artwork I would find on like a Join the Empire, enlist today.
Yeah,
just like
absolutely.
A Death Trooper standing in battle, like firing his blaster out. There's like blast explosions going off in the background and stuff.
It's the most intimidating trooper that we have, and it should be. It's one of those cases where the art once again shows so well the scene that was in and how dangerous those troopers
there's a lot
were.
There's a lot of tone in that scene where in the background you can tell how much calamity is going on, and for this trooper to just be standing up and going into it, I mean, there must be something special. Of course we know they are. They're insanely good. In the Rogue One movie, they're like so intimidating. They've got like the garbled voice like technology, so it sounds like they're not even human to grant more intimidation. I think it's perfectly captured in this where the Death Trooper looks like and feels like they're in control of the situation. This one doesn't necessarily scream blue card, but one thing I like about it, and that's difficult with armor that's all black, but one thing I like that they did really nicely is the background of Scarif is all of those bright, vibrant colors, which helps to contrast the Death Trooper's dark, plasticky armor.
And I'd known that Reese was talking about that they talked in like garbled voices before. I just started reading. I've just finished reading all the Darth Vader books. I didn't realize all their dialogue was just like muffled out. And Darth Vader's being yes, absolutely.
Because they talk on encrypted channels.
So that was hilarious.
So it is funny. Some other artwork that I think is absolutely wonderful: the Palpatine leader, arguably a leader that looks as good as its showcase.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Like, that showcase is beautiful, but also just the regular, like, getting out that hyperspace Palpatine out there, and even the regular one, he looks like you're in for a bad time.
I think that Boya captures tone really well. Entrenched is another card they have, and when you look at the artwork of Entrenched, you can just tell that, like, you can see the faces of those soldiers, the battle that's going on. Like, they don't want to be there. They're not happy to be on Mimban, like, with Han Solo being conscripts. It's a bad time with Woody Harrelson running around blasting everyone. So you really get a feel for it, which is how your opponent feels when you entrench their Devastator. They go, oh, please don't put me in the trenches. And then finally, some fan favorite artwork. I have a lot of friends who like this card for some reason. Don't get cocky. Ah. Card's effect is interesting, but the artwork is awesome, and I really think it captures the scene where Luke's just, I got one. Great job, kid. Don't get cocky. I think it captures that well. I love it so much, and I think they did an absolutely fantastic job. I love my troopers, so my next one is another one, but we'll move on to James.
Yeah, my next one is one that I think is overlooked a little bit sometimes. It is Force Throw. I think that Art of Vader is probably... And there's a lot of fantastic Art of Vader in this set. That art is stylized so specifically. And I think my favorite part of this art is the fact that they made an event with Vader in it and somehow made Vader look incredibly intimidating.
Yeah.
But not the main focus of the card.
I was going to say, actually... Force Choke and I Am Your Father are awesome cards. They have beautiful artwork and they frame Vader. They don't necessarily show the power of Vader, but this has Vader off to the side in the background as he's hurling large objects at you. Just show, and it looks like he's not using any effort.
No.
Like his lightsaber's out and he's got his hand low, flicking
he's
like
just
that.
Like,
and
yeah.
There is like chunks of metal coming towards you, which, gorgeous. That is exactly what I want to see from one of personally my favorite characters, and someone who is so hyped up to be so powerful and capturing Darth Vader's actual true power.
Yeah, absolutely.
Is insane.
And the stylization of this card I think is fantastic. It takes on a much more comic book kind of vibe to it, and that's the case with
like
all
it's out of,
of
the Vader comics.
It's one of those things that is in all of this person's. Her name is. Elena Skitaltas. I definitely screwed that up. I'm very sorry, but...
Sorry. We're sorry.
But her art is fantastic, and it's one of those cases where they haven't done a lot of art for the set, but being art that has been done for it is around that similar style, and I really like that style a lot. So stuff like Rugged Survivors, that fucking comic
fellas.
Book group, like that group of fellas.
That was our first group of fellas, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, believe
no,
it was
no.
Valiant.
It was
Valiant
Vigilant Honor
Guard. Vigilant Honor Guard.
Yeah, but this was a group of fellas that we
like. It is a group of fellas that we like, especially the art of it. I think the art of it really captures the ruggedness of these survivors. but like, yeah, the Force Throw is. Very, very cool, and I have it in Hyperspace Foil again, and it's just one of those cards that is so pretty in the fold and so pretty to look at. Another one that I'd like to throw out for this artist is Wolf. I think they did a really good job of capturing Wolf. I know it came out a lot later in the set and isn't used a lot that I've seen, but Wolf, the artwork for Wolf, I think is really cool. I think they really captured just kind of the get him alone kind of
old man Wolf.
Old man Wolf.
Crunchety. The Jedi have come back to take their revenge.
Yeah, absolutely. And so it's one of those cases where I think, for me, the art style of this and being and really shows. The ability, the freedom that they're given the artists to take their own style into the game. And I think that's really important because I think if all the art was done by, like, say, one person, yes, that would be cool, varied art, but they would all be under the same kind of banner of a certain type of style. Whereas I think that one of the big things
I like
about having
style.
Having multiple artists, like lots of different artists, some doing like 10 cards, some doing like 4 cards. It's really, really cool.
I think the
cool.
lowest is 3. I think there's only 3. There's the next, one of the next people I'm talking about only did 3 cards in the whole set. One of them is a showcase.
One of mine also did only 3 cards in the set. And that is my number one.
Oh, spicy. All in all, the artwork is gorgeous. My favorite thing about the artwork, right, is you get people who are like, yeah, I hate the artwork. And then those same people will be like, look at this really pretty hyperspace output. And then you're like, okay, buddy.
Right,
I bet you hate that artwork.
Yeah.
Next one. I love my troopers.
He does.
You love your troopers. I love Scarif and Rogue One. Season Shore Trooper.
Mm.
This artwork is so good. Every time I look at this card, I'm so thankful that it's playable.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because I just want to run it. I probably would run this card all the time, even if it sucked. And it doesn't.
Ooh.
Because the artwork is just that good that I'm like, I really want this in my deck.
Look at this more. Yeah,
I love it. I love troopers. I love the synergies. I like armor. I think I love just the trooper armor. And painting it's really fun. I can't imagine how fun it would have been to draw this. Once again, the colors of this card are beautiful. This artwork is done by Milos Slavkovic. Sorry if I mispronounced it again. But the artwork on this is gorgeous. I love that you can tell the background is Scarif, but it's actually really simplistic. If you actually take some time to look at the background, there's not a lot of detail going in. It's mainly block colors. But the detail in the Shore Trooper is there, and that really like lends to just the focus, drawing the eye. I know where this character is. I like that it shows, again, like a mid-battle position, firing his gun. I know there was a joke early on of another guy firing their gun. But, like, what else are the troopers going to do? Like,
yeah, I think for me personally, I think it would have been really easy for them to take all the troopers and all the bad guys and put them in the dull colors and the dark side. But I think this they've done a really good job on a lot of different cards on keeping everything vibrant and alive.
Absolutely.
And I think this is one of the key ones that shows that.
Color is one of the biggest things Star Wars Unlimited does good.
Mm, absolutely.
In terms of art. One thing I love about this as well is that the camera angle, the shot of the character is like a close set, like really close shot. And it's almost like you can feel that Shore Trooper taking aim and firing deliberately. He's a seasoned Shore Trooper. This time I pick Pepper. And I absolutely love it. Some other art by Milos. Baze Malbus. The artwork for Baze.
Do like the artwork for Baze.
Bail Organa, again. Some fantastic artwork. Two really good characters done really good justice. And finally, First Legion Snowtrooper. Another trooper done incredibly well. In a very similar pose. One thing I love about the troopers is a lot of their artwork is tied together by a few things.
Mm.
And I love that it isn't just that they're all just guys standing there in uniformity. It's that all these troopers are doing something. And you can tell they're troopers just by looking at the card. But it's not just like, oh, I can tell they're troopers because they're all standing there. I can tell they're troopers. I can tell it's a trooper when I look at it. But it's because I can't put my finger on it, but you just know.
Yeah.
And I really love that. I love how all of the artists managed to capture that uniformity in the set.
My next person, I really like two of the art pieces on this one. And looking at them together, they are kind of inverses of each other art-wise. And I think that's a really cool thing that they've done. And one of the things that is really interesting about both these cards, and they're both gorgeous cards, the artist we're talking about is Ash Pierce. And the two cards that we're talking about is The Force Is With Me, a fantastic card of that scene with Churrit, where he is essentially walking towards to send the signal.
Yep.
And
so that Bodhi can hook it up and
absolutely,
tell the fellas
and it's just, it's one of those things again where we can talk about that Scarif background and how well they've incorporated that Scarif background into a lot of different artworks. This one as well, that bright background contrasted by the dark clothes Churrit is wearing.
The vibrant red, because a lot of that, like Churrit's dark clothes are still blue, so it blends in with the bluey, cold greens and yellows. And then the vibrant red blaster shots going past him. And also, there's those line pulls to show the action in the situation.
Absolutely.
Show Churrit walking through, showing how fast everything's moving, but he seems calm, which is exactly the scene. That captures exactly the scene.
Everything around Churrit is blurred and motioned, but Churrit is very still in the image, and I think that really pulls you into the image and really shows you. The other one that kind of, I think, contrasts this art-wise pretty well is Precision Fire. It's this artwork
of just a trooper. Love troopers.
It's a very still piece of art.
Yep.
But it has an intensity to it.
Because he's lining up that shot. He's not going to miss. And the art captures, like, the water behind him is calm. There is no blurs. Mm. Everything's set. Everything's, like, there's no motion. And you can tell that that stormtrooper is just, like, holding his breath.
Yeah.
Ready to pull the trigger.
Absolutely. And this, I was talking about, it was kind of an inverse. This is the stark white of the stormtrooper completely contrasts the dark background.
Yeah,
grays. You can see this is at night. Yeah. He's on some sort of mission. He's lining up that shot. You almost hold your breath looking at this art. And it's one of those arts that I think both of these arts.
I also think that the artwork for both of them matches up with the cards quite well.
Mm.
You know, and again, this is a testament to the game designers and the artists for just making things that fit. Like, when I see The Forces With Me, this is the scene exactly, down to a T, in both ability and art.
Absolutely.
Same with Precision Fire. Using a trooper to attack to give a buff as if he's going in for a snipe. Like, giving something saboteur. But then, if it's a trooper doing it, they're going in for using the sniper.
They don't care if you got shields on. They've got their shot lined up.
Yep.
They're ready to take it.
For the Empire.
No, both of these arts are really cool, and I really like them a lot. And I think both of them really showcase the
card.
Other cards that they did was known, not readable, Wilderness Fighter.
On Echo Base, but not defending it.
Not defending.
He was there. He fought, but not in defensive.
And C-3PO from the starter deck, which is a really interesting one. That I think was really cool.
Droid?
It's the protocol droid himself, the man, the myth, the legend.
Interestingly enough, is R2-D2 on that list?
No. He's the only four cards that this person did for this.
Oh. My next one is a three-card person. And admittedly, one of my favorite, if not my favorite, artworks from this set. Is the Darth Vader Commanding the First Legion by Ivan Denov. I saw this art and went, I hope it's on a mat. And then they revealed it as a mat. And I didn't shut up about getting that mat until the game came out.
And then he got that mat.
And I didn't shut up about it.
It's extremely good artwork. Everybody knows what's happening. Everybody knows. And it's one of the most intimidating scenes and
Falcon's
figures
just
of...
left, and Vader has just taken over all of Echo Base.
Mm-hmm.
And there he is standing on a rock, imposingly. Again, like, he's standing on a rock, he's got that commanding presence, lightsaber drawn,
mm-hmm.
stark black armor contrasting all of the whites. excuse me. And then the stormtroopers, the snowtroopers coming up behind him. Like, you can tell, like, that's his legion. There they are.
That's it.
Whew, this is some good artwork.
Oh, it's so
nice. Ivan Denov outdid himself, in my opinion. Now, the only other artworks are the Han Solo Showcase. Again, you can't go wrong with a showcase. I think it looks really, really nice. And the Thrawn Leader.
Thrawn Leader is one of my favorite artworks. And, like, I think they nailed the Thrawn artwork so well. And I think the only... it's just such an, it captures Thrawn so well.
Yep, it's perfect for Thrawn. I love it. They didn't do a lot, but I think what they did do in this set, they did incredibly well. And all I can say is I look forward to the next Legendary that Ivan gets their hands on.
Yeah, absolutely.
What's up next?
Well, you're talking about Vader, and I think I'm going to stick with Vader. Because the one I'm bringing up for my fourth pick is Power of the Dark Side. Fantastic card, fantastic art.
We've got a lot of Rogue One artwork. I think, hold on. Was it one, two, three? Three of my five are Rogue One. And you're doing Power of the Dark Side. And
we like Rogue One, what can we say?
And Forces With Me. So two Chirrut's, three Vader cards, and a lot of troopers.
But no, this art is very, very cool. I think it's one of the... Yeah, it's absolutely beautiful.
It's awesome.
It's a Vader. He's holding up a rebel using the Force. It's just effortless.
Two other dead rebels on the floor.
Yeah, absolutely. It's him cutting swaths through rebel scum.
And the artwork is... I love how it's framed where the rebel is lifting up and you can see the light coming from behind them. But everything else in the card is as if it's choking out. Like, I love how... the shadows in this artwork reflect Vader choking the rebel because the artwork around it is, it's literally, if you notice the shadows on this card, it's choking out the light Vader is moving forward. This scene is iconic. And the fact that once again, we get a card that's effect and artwork captures the tone and power of this character incredibly well.
We'll say that the artist for this is Eslam Aboshady. Go check him out. He's fantastic. As well as this art, he's also done a bunch of other artworks that are really cool in the set. Ones that we can talk about is Takedown. I think that Takedown artwork
is awesome.
so nice.
I'm just kicking someone in the jaw.
Absolutely. And as much as... it's one of those cases where if you go to the store showdown, you're going to get a brand new alt art Takedown. It's like...
but I have
this is a hard choice.
I have choices of the original. Like, I'm probably going to run both.
No, yeah. But, like, the fact that it's a hard choice shows how good this artwork is and how good this showcases that someone's getting taken down.
Ooh. And then also, Chewbacca walking carpet. And
the Sabine leader, as you know and love.
All in all, incredibly good artwork. I love how the power of the dark side captures it. But we don't just like the dark side. We just love the Force. And once again, it's with him. My final card is the Chirrut Showcase. I really love this showcase. And for me, it's a hard toss-up between Hera and this. But I love, once again, I think the camera angle of this where Chirrut's looking up. He's got his, like, bow staff out. Yeah. And then you've got the palm tree looming over him. I am a sucker for tropical environments. I love them. I've loved them ever since I was a kid when I would go on a holiday to Bali and Thailand. But I love, again, the reflection of this in the card artwork. I think Chirrut looks incredible. This card is so colorful and so gorgeous. And the minimalistic text boxes and health and everything circling it look incredible. I am upset that I haven't gotten this showcase yet, and it's one I would consider personally buying. Potentially might be saving my money for the showcases coming out next set, though, because there are some doozies, hopefully. But I love this artwork. Once again, I think it encapsulates the character really nicely. He's got a bit of a smirk. And I don't know. I can't get over how colorful and gorgeous it is.
Yeah,
I could look at it for hours. Other art, this is by Ario Murti. Again, I'm so sorry. but some other artwork, absolute big hitters in the set. Del Mico, I love the framing on Del Mico as it looks like he's just kicked you down and is pointing the sniper down at you.
Yeah.
Heroic Sacrifice.
Such a good piece of art.
This artwork is gorgeous.
Why do we love Rogue One so much?
It's just because Rogue One's good, man. I have this card in hyperspace foil, and I will often be sitting there like, and my opponent will be like, what are you doing for your turn? And I'm like, oh, pay one. Heroic sacrifice. Look how pretty it is. And they're like, that doesn't seem very optimal. And I'm like, look how pretty it is. and then, of course, shoot first. Bah! Han Solo McClunkying people and captured just absolutely beautifully in this. There was a lot of other artwork done by Ario. I believe also including the artwork for Wanted from
that is
set,
coming
two.
Out set two. Absolutely.
There we go.
One of my favorites by him is Buddy Rook.
Body Rook, another Rogue One character.
I love the purples behind him make the hyperspace of this card really pop.
Yeah, just I really like the anxiety in Body because you can tell, and he was anxious the whole movie. No, that boy was not well.
No.
And it just didn't go right for him ever since he met... was it Galen Erso? Did not go good. But he did his part for the cause he believes in. We got one.
A guy that is not on this list, apparently.
You know what? Yeah, I was close. Hey, I was close to putting the Cassian K2 and for a cause on. Anyway, it's too much. It's too much Rogue One. So I went for Chirrut, Stormtrooper, Deathtrooper.
Now get to my favorite art from the set. And this artist, their name is Liana Anatolvic.
Just quickly, did you know that one of my favorite music artists recently released a new hit?
God damn it.
He's actually a DJ.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's a Death Star DJ.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And is it the DJ beat drop?
It is the DJ beat drop!
Oh, this card is so pretty. And I want to highlight all three cards that this person has made because they are so nice. The first one that we saw was Devotion. I think Devotion is such a pretty card.
The swirling fog really gets me every time.
The swirls that this person puts into are so pretty. And I just stare at them constantly. Talk about a blue card being a blue card.
Right?
Devotion is so perfectly what it is. A lot
of their art's really angular.
The regional sympathizers that they did, that kind of like
explosions,
dark like skidding sparks. Yeah, and so even nice. Then there's like the swirls that kind of encapsulate their art really, really well. And Super Laser Blast is just so
it's
gorgeous.
It's really intimidating. It's like I look at that card and I'm like, ah, yes, impending doom. Like I look at that card and I'm like,
I'm currently on the search for that in hyperspace foil. I have a hyperspace, but I do not have a
ever
hyperspace foil.
Ever since it was released, James was like, when we got our 10 boxes, he turned to me and he's like, I don't care if I don't get a showcase. As long as I get a hyperspace foil Super Laser Blast.
I'll get one eventually.
And he was like, I would prefer that. And I was like, I can't believe that, man.
Oh, I love this art so much. I think it's such a good card. And I think it's such pretty art that I want to just stare at all day.
The art, once again, the artwork says so much. If you showed me this card with no text on it, I could confidently tell you that it says Destroy All Units.
Yeah.
I love it. I think it's gorgeous. And if there's one thing I'd love to request, it's more from that artist.
Mm, absolutely. I think that, especially going into set two, there's some really cool characters coming out. I would love to see some more art from that artist. I think they're my favorite cards of set one. And you can tell I love that kind of stylized feel that a lot of these Swoo cards bring. A lot of my cards that I picked were those kind of like more stylized type cards, but I love them so much. And I particularly love Super Laser Blast, Devotion, and Regional Sympathizers. I think those three cards all are just so pretty.
Now. Shadows of the Galaxy! It is set to art time because we got a buttload of artwork from the stream.
Yeah, we're just gonna be throwing out. We're not gonna go over every single piece of art that's been released because we'll be here all day and
all
tomorrow.
Day.
But we are gonna highlight a couple ones that we've seen that have kind of sparked our interest.
Salacious Crumb! Look at him! Yeah. Look at him go! That confirms Jabba for me as a leader.
Because
like we got Bib Fortuna, we got the Rancor on the art on the mat, and we got Salacious. If they don't give us Jabba, but all of the fellas who surround him, what am I going to do? We've also seen Jabba on the poster. So, I want to quickly talk about the three pieces of artwork they revealed. One was revealed today that I'm personally most excited for.
Can you guess what it is? Because I can guess what it is.
They're troopers.
They are troopers.
They'll be troopers. They'll be clones. They'll be underworld. They'll be the Bad Batch, boy.
Oh, the art for the Bad Batch has come out so far. We've got three, and they're all super pretty.
They're all incredible.
We have Tech, we have Echo, and we have Hunter.
Echo's artwork looks so much like him.
Yeah, and it's like leaning out and taking a shot.
When I first saw, again, like the We don't know the, unfortunately, the images, the stills we have currently don't have the names of the artists. But we will revisit that in my set 2. I'm calling it now. My set 2 is probably going to be a lot of Bad Batch because I'm a sucker for those boys. Echo looks incredible. I saw this and had to double take because I almost thought it was actually a still from the show. Like, I was like, huh? What? And then, like, looked again. So good. Captured his likeness incredibly well. Mm. I will talk now about Hunters quickly.
Yeah, I think Hunters is really, really nicely done.
It looks so nice.
I think, like, armor is just so well encapsulated in a lot of artwork in Su.
I love where he is. I'm looking at a picture right now. Because it came out today. I woke up and was like, ooh. He sent me a message like, look at this boy. How could I not? I like that his position, his stance, it is the character, but he's on a mission. He's sneaking around.
He's got the knife out.
He's doing Bad Batch things. My favorite of the artwork revealed so far, and I would dare say probably my favorite remaining to be after the rest of them get revealed, is Tech. Because they say in the stream, he's a lover, not a fighter. And the artwork on this is gorgeous. He's standing in the doorway of the Marauder, the light from inside casting over him, the darkness of the outside while it's raining. I can feel this scene. I love this artwork. I also love this one, because I think Han Solo saying, get a load of this guy, is really funny. what's some of your favorite set to art they've shown?
Some of my favorite set to art, the one that I have to shout out immediately that I think is just so gorgeous is that shot of the Millennium Falcon flying through the debris field.
Slave One? Fire spray, Slave One, whatever. Looking at, like down at it.
Oh, it's such a pretty... So whatever good. That card is going to be so pretty.
It's going to be awesome, man.
It's such a nice-looking card, that one. I think one of the things that's got me really excited is how good both of the Aphra arts are that we've seen.
I really like the new one.
I've just started reading all the comics and the audiobooks of Aphra. And part of that was because I saw how good the art was. And I was like, I knew, like, this character, but like, I want to...
I like how it captures her playfulness where she's clearly falling, but she's just got her gun out. She's got a big smile on her face. Yeah. And I like that as well in her bag. You can see like a glint of like the gold stuff. She's clearly stolen from someone, and she's now making her escape. And she's like,
which is 80%
of Aphra stories,
just escaping things. It's wonderful. I think it's one of the, like, I think they've nailed her character really well in both of the arts. So like that, the fact that we have two arts though is really promising. Hopefully we're getting a leader and a unit, or maybe it's just going to be a unit event, something. But I'm really hoping for
any
an
Aphra
leader. I think
Aphra.
It's going to be fantastic.
I've got a good feeling about getting one. Boba Fett into chair is also really sick. This is really the Daimyo Boba Fett from the Boba Fett. It's really
like,
cool.
Such an intimidating figure, that one. I think that's extremely pretty.
And some art, one piece of art I don't think that we should go without talking about because I think it's gorgeous, is the Quarren Bounty Hunter.
Yes, absolutely. I think that is...
There's a few details I actually really like about this. I like how dynamic it is, but there's two main things I really like. A, he's got a DC-15A blaster carbine, which is this Clone Wars standard issue long-range rifle. I think that's awesome that he's using one. And he's got a tracking fob. He's got like the Bounty Hunter tracking fob on him.
Yep.
From the Mando series, where they introduced, it was always there, but they, like, you know, more relevantly pushed it forward and were like, this is what bounty hunters do to track people. I think it's awesome. And just for like a generic, what I would imagine is a generic guy, looks sweet.
Absolutely. And we can't talk about set 2 without talking about the 2 starter deck leaders, both done by the same artist.
Yeah.
We'll put your name up here for you. I can't remember off the top of my head, but both starter deck leaders were done by the same artist, and they've done a fantastic job of kind of, we've seen the box as well, and it's just so pretty on the box, and those two artworks meld together so well, as you would expect with,
I think it's Eric Hibbler.
There you go. Shout out to Eric. You did a fantastic job with both of these leaders. And set 2 is just going to be so cool and so interesting.
My favorite artwork from set 2 so far, though.
I know it.
Lando Calrissian, baby. Look at this artwork a while ago.
Look at him. We saw it in a, I believe it was.
It was an investors kind of slideshow, right? Yeah, slideshow for game stores. They're talking about weekly play, and this slide came up. I got so excited. I was like, it has to be set to.
Then you thought it might not be set to after everything else came out, started coming out, and then it got revealed in this stream, and you're like,
I got so excited. I may be, again, huffing my copium, but when they were talking about this artwork and stuff, it seemed like they were implying that he's going to be the leader that focuses on the smuggler ability or smuggle ability. And man, I hope that's true, because I am genuinely a huge Donald Glover fan, and I am a... I actually really like the Solo movie, unpopular opinion. I really like it. I'm a movie buff, and I love that movie. So getting a character that I think is really cool, I loved him in that movie, and one of my favorite actors and musicians ever on like a card.
Absolutely.
Makes me really happy.
No, absolutely. And it's one of those cases where it looks so, so pretty and it's so, so cool. Speaking of Smuggle though, next week we're going to be going
over the stream.
There's a stream next week that is all about Smuggle, Capture, and Bounty. They're going to be showing off some cards of each, going through the keywords in detail. And that's what we're going to be talking about next week as well. We're going to be talking about those keywords, how we think it's going to affect the format, how we think they're going to bring it in, what cards, we're going to predict cards into the future, talk about the set, and I think it's going to be really cool. But so tune in next week to have a look at that.
I'm so excited, man. I actually can't contain myself.
It's wild. We're so close, yet so far from the release of set two, and I remember waiting 9 months for the release of set one, and it's only what, like...
It feels so quick.
Yeah.
Like, I was talking to my boss yesterday, because I was like, oh, I got to book some time. Like, I've got to book time off for the stream and the pre-release events. So, he was like, yeah, just punch it in. And I turned around and I, like, clicked, like, twice to get through to the next month. And I was like, wow, it's, like, barely any time away from when we have pre-releases. So, spoiler season's going to go fast.
Absolutely.
And it's so exciting.
Keen for that to so get started. Excited. It starts next week officially, and we are so excited. You're going to see all the spoilers here on the Spy Squadron podcast.
We're going to go through them again, just like we did set one.
You will get every single one. You'll get every single one graded on
fresh
the Spy-someter.
Fresh Spy-someter rating for them all.
But tune in. Check out our gameplays as well. We have one this week that's going to be quite interesting. It's going to be as the lovely
Churrit
coming through versus the Han Solo.
Both green.
So check that out. And we will see you
next week.
Bye.